Hi friends, Chris here. Step into my den for a little bit. Let's learn more about making proper biblical judgments. Our theme for a couple of weeks here is In My Judgment. Today I want to talk about pointing fingers, or as they say, pointing your bony finger. Listen, God gave you a finger to direct and point people to the cross and point them to heaven. It's not necessarily to point out their flaws and their sins. You know, when I point one finger at you, there's three more pointing at me and one shooting over there towards Deb somewhere. So let's learn about the proper way to make judgments, and that is number one, don't judge according to appearance. We've already shared this, so I don't need to spend much time on it. Don't judge a book by its cover. In 2 Corinthians 10 and verse 7, do you look on things after the outward appearance? Well, we're not supposed to. 1 Samuel 16 and 7, man looks on the outward appearance, but God looks on the heart. You know, an angel of light looks good on the outside. A wolf in sheep clothing looks good on the outside. A sonic chili dog with cheese looks good on the outside, but don't judge a chili dog by its cover. Number two, don't make premature judgments, you know, or snap judgments, I could call it. 1 Corinthians 4 and 5, judge nothing before the time until the Lord shall come. In other words, God may be doing something in somebody's life, and if you start jumping to conclusions and interfering, you can mess things up. If you jump to conclusions, you jump the gun. You need to wait on God, because love suffers long and love is patient with people. And then number three, don't judge according to a fleshly prism. Now we call this program Through the Prism of Chrism because I've got ways that I see things and you have a way to see things, but it has to be a spiritual prism. It can't be a fleshly prism. 2 Corinthians again, chapter 5 and verse 16, from henceforth we know no man after the flesh. The New International Version says, from now on we regard no one from a worldly point of view. Though we once regarded Christ in this way, yet we do so no longer. You have to judge by the Spirit, not the flesh, because the Spirit not only sees what is, the Spirit sees what can become. Number four, don't judge by making unwise comparisons with other people. 2 Corinthians again, chapter 10 and verse 12, they measuring themselves by themselves and comparing themselves with themselves are not wise. It's not wise to judge by comparison. You know, somebody says to her husband, I wish you'd be more like Travis. Well, who's Travis? It's somebody, some actor on a soap opera that she watches. And he's had three divorces in his life, and his wife doesn't even like him. She's comparing by something unrealistic. And then that same woman says, I just don't trust his judgments or his decisions anymore. Well, let me ask something. Did he make a judgment when he decided to marry you? Well, enough said. Number five, don't judge with a bunch of preconceptions or without having all the facts. You know, if we're going to make a judgment, make sure you have all the facts. Does it take two to tango? Well, you've only heard one side of the story. There's his version, there's her version, and then there's the true version, which lies somewhere in between. And then number six, don't be unsympathetic in making judgments. James 2 and verse 13, he shall have judgment without mercy who has showed no mercy, and mercy rejoices against judgment. You know, in the Beatitudes it says, blessed are they that are merciful, for they shall obtain mercy. Mercy rejoices against judgment. And in Psalm 18 and verse 15, verse 25, with the merciful you will show yourself merciful, and in the next verse, with the froward or with the contradictory, you will show yourself contradictory. So you can have it either way, and if you want mercy, you need to be merciful. And then number seven, let's close with this. Don't be a hypocrite about it. In Romans 2 and verse 1, he says, thou hypocrite, you that judges another, you do the same thing. And verse 3 of that chapter says, listen, do you think this, O man, you who judge those practicing such things and doing the same, that you will escape the judgment of God? It's not going to happen. Jared Dougherty is a comedian friend of mine here in Branson, and he said, trouble with Baptists, and it can be Baptists or it can be Pentecostals or anybody, because it's true with everybody. The trouble with Baptists, if one goes fishing with you, he'll drink all your beer, but if two go fishing with you, they won't drink any of it. That's hypocrisy. Chris here, I hope you're enjoying this series on In My Judgment. Tune in tomorrow. We got a little bit more for a couple more days, and then we'll move on to another subject. But God bless you. Have a great day in the Lord.